Who is Veronica Solomon? Well, I'm a Christian woman, first and foremost. I'm a mom to two kids and a dog, if you want to count Rufus. I'm also a businesswoman and entrepreneur and owner and lead designer for Casa Vilora Interiors. I am a sister, a daughter, and I am a mentor to other designers, and I minister to other people and kind of help out in the community. My journey into interior design, well, it's a long one, but in a nutshell, I grew up in Jamaica, not really knowing what interior design was all about. And when I moved here to the United States and discovered that you can make a living doing something like this, being creative and bringing beauty to somebody else's life, I was very intrigued by that. Eventually, I went back to school and ended up opening my business a few years later, some 11 years ago, actually. Okay, what family's like as an entrepreneur? I'll say it's a mix of rewarding and challenging at the same time. You have to learn how to balance your time, know when to kind of put extra hours into the business and when to focus on the children. So it was always a balancing act. The kids are a little bit older now, so they can relate to what I had to do to keep the business going, but it's been wonderful. My daughter, Courtney. Well, first of all, she reminds me so much of me, but she's a college student now. She's 21 years old and she's finally home again for a few days, and I'm really enjoying that so far. But she's very, very creative. She loves to paint and draws very well. She works very hard and very independent. And like I said, reminds me so much of how I was when I was her age, but actually she's a little bit, you know, better than I was at that age. But I just love her, I love my kids.
Hi, I'm Courtney Morris, daughter of Veronica Solomon. I live in Miami right now because I'm going to FIU for school, for hospitality, and that's a little bit about me. Growing up with a designer mom was very fun and interesting because, like, you'd come home one day and the room's decorated completely different than it was last week. So it was really cool to experience her creativity through my life, especially because I'm a creative person as well. So it was really interesting to see that stuff. How her interior design impacted me was because I'm an oil painter myself. I love to paint. So she just showed me that anything you put your mind to, you can do it as long as you just focus on what you love instead of like just the daily worries and stress. About her passion, I think it's honestly amazing. It makes me wanna like be better at what I wanna do, even though I'm not too clear on what I want. I'm majoring in hospitality now, but she's kind of pushing me towards design right now as well. But yeah, it's just like inspirational to see how far she's come from nothing to something, you know.
And Joshua, he is a free spirit, I will say. He has his own idea of fun and his own idea of what he wants to do. Strong-willed, but still loving, very kind, very caring. And he just lightens my life, but he's a pain sometimes too, like they both are.
I'm Joshua, I'm 16, I go to Katy High School. Well, from day one, she's always been hardworking, very smart about a lot of stuff, you know. Well, I see her work and like, it makes me wanna like draw something out. I get inspired every time she does something. Her being a mom and a businesswoman is both very great. She's very good at both of them. I feel like she's pretty famous.
Yeah. Veronica at home, let's see. Well, I'm always collecting things. I'm a big collector of books, and I also collect white pottery and ceramics. And I love just mixing things up in my own home. I'm always tinkering with moving things around. And but I like to relax in my own home. I like to work a lot, so my environment that I work in has to be very organized. But sometimes it's chaotic at the same time. But when I'm home, I like to feel a sense of serenity and the feeling that I'm in my own space. The Savvy Chic movement, I'm calling it a movement, but basically Savvy Chic just means that you have your own version of luxury, basically. So yes, it takes an investment to redo your home or decorate or redo a remodel. But there's some things that you can do stylishly that doesn't cost you a ton of money. And it's just a matter of knowing how to mix it and match it and make it work for you. a lot of times you will need the help of a professional like me to kind of guide you on the right path. And that's what my Savage Chic community is all about, is just inviting people into it and teaching them just how they can express their own version of luxury in their homes. The inspiration is just a passion that I have. I mean, I really want my heart to be in anything that I do. I've been accused lately of running my business with heart, which is absolutely true. And I use the word accused because at first I was just like, huh, people notice that. Because I really believe in what I do. I know it seems frivolous and it seems like you're just spending money buying stuff for people's homes. But the reality is you get to go into their space and you get to know them, you get to know their families, and then you get to help them live their ideal lives in their home. And there's nothing more rewarding than that.